Good morning, everyone. A gute Woche, Shavua Tov. We are continuing here in the Birchas Hanenen, the blessings of food, drink, and fragrances that we derive benefit from. Says the Kitzur, Avali Mehem Shnei Minim. However, if the foods that are in front of you are two different species, two different types, which, as we're going to see, means that the bracha rishayna, the first blessing that you're going to make on them, is not the same. Kegoyin priya eitz, if you have a fruit, or priya adama, you have a vegetable, you have an apple, and you have a carrot. Oidavashi b'chosa shahakoil, you have also, let's say, a piece of cheese or a piece of meat that is there, and the blessing on that is shahakol. Afal gav de b'dievedim bercha kulam shahakol, even though, as we spoke about before, that in a secondary way, meaning after the fact, if you made the blessing of Shahakoil on anything, you covered your bases. Or if on an apple, you made the blessing of Borei Pri Adama, which is that you're thanking Hashem that He creates things from the ground, since the tree grows from the ground, and even though the apple is coming from the tree, but it's still connected to the ground. So therefore, Yotza, you would have fulfilled your obligation if you made that blessing as well on a tree. Nevertheless, Mikol Malkoim Lechadchila Asal Asais Kein. However, Lechadchila, in the best possible way to perform the mitzvah and say the blessing, you should not say the wrong bracha. Ela Yivarech Al Kol Echad V'Echad Bracha Miyuchedes Loi. Rather, on each and everything, on a fruit, you say ha'etz. On a vegetable, you say ha'adama. And on meat, cheese, beverages, and so on and so forth, you say shahakol. And on mezainais, on cake and cookies and crackers, you make a mezainais. And as we'll see, on grape juice, you make berpia gafen. And so on and so forth. Every food that has an individual bracha, as we've spoken about before, that's the way that a person should make their blessings on the foods that they eat. Ubirchas borei priya eitz kaidemis, says the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, when you have an apple and a carrot and a glass of water in front of you, which bracha comes first? So you take the one that is the hierarchy of blessings, and a eitz is a more defined bracha than that which is on ha'adama and that which is on shahakol. And therefore you should say ha'eitz, the blessing of Borei Pri Ha'etz, that who creates the fruit of the tree, that one should come first. Now, we'll see later on in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch that there are conditions that would change this, that if the other food that's in front of you is something that you like much more than the apple that is there, we will see situations where you could say a blessing, let's say, on the carrot before you do it on the apple. But we will see there as we get there in chapter 55, God willing. Now he writes, V'afilu yesh lefanav yayin v'anovim. Let's say you have in front of you wine and grapes. V'reitza lishtois yayin koidim. And you want to drink the wine first. U'mavarach borei pri hagafen. And of course you want to make the blessing of borei pri hagafen. Afal pi shim hu mischaven lifter bivracha zu. Says the Kitzur, and a fascinating thing. If you make the bracha of Borei Pri HaGafen and you make it on the wine, but you have grapes that are on the table, and you have in mind that you want the grapes to be covered by this blessing as well, so then you don't have to say a blessing anymore on the grapes. So if that's the case, then you made one bracha and you covered two things. And we just finished saying over here that really a person should make one bracha on each thing that is necessary. He should divide up his blessings for all the different types of food. Says the Kitzur lecharchila, which means in the best possible way of fulfilling the blessings over here, don't do such a thing. Ella, what should you do? When you make the blessing on the wine, have specific intention not to allow the blessing on the wine to cover the blessing on the grapes. In order that after you drank the wine, which you should make that bracha first, that's the highest bracha in the blessing chain, then you'll be able to take a grape in your hand and make a bracha on the grape as well, borei pri ha'etz. And in that way, as we've been saying all along, you'll be able to fulfill the blessings in the best possible way, which is on each thing that you eat, you make the individual bracha that is related to that. Wishing everybody a wonderful day. We still have a few halachas left in this chapter to go. I look forward to continuing with you tomorrow, Be'ez Hashem. All the best. Shavua Tov.